en el, o sea, en Martinero.
Los bosques de mi juventud, bueno, esos son bebidas de memorias. Posible con esta de tener todas las flores. So you try the pulp and it's not very sweet. There are flowers, rose, lavender, a little bit of rosemary. And the alcohol is right in the back. It's sweet, extremely sweet in comparison to this, which is not very sweet. Oh, incredible transformation. It's like going from a larvae to a butterfly. It's 48% alcohol, so it'll be 96 proof. Wow. The bouquet continues as it evaporates inside the cavities of your mouth. It's something unbelievable. I've never tried anything like this. Ahorita es como difícil de explicar algo que nunca lo he probado.
Como un sabor a viejo, a libros viejos.
Este también me sabe como a carne.
Wow. 14 to 16 years in the earth.
En promedio, llegan a pesar, están más o menos grandes, pero en promedio llegan a pesar como unos 30 kilos.
Each one of these cones weighs about 30 kilos, so about 75 pounds, 80 pounds.
Para hacer un litro.
To make 1 liter.
Necesitamos alrededor de 22 kilos.
You need 22 kilos to make 1 liter. So, this is the sacrifice. What a delicious fruit. I mean, this is like meat. This is like eating meat. And we're going to see what happens now.
Ya lo que la tendencia industrial quieren hacer. O como la producción en masa. Hace las cosas bien, es de contexto.
52%. 52. It's 104 proof. 104 proof. The process goes over here, where each and every piece is tasted by the distillers to make sure that it is of the same quality and the same general flavor characteristics of the flavor they're trying to emulate, so that every single batch tastes similar. The quantity of sugar is going to change every time. But the customers say that the flavor never changes. That's the interesting thing. But this is the process. It's absolutely painstakingly slow, but done in order to have the highest quality mezcal that you can find in Mexico. There are two large stones that go into this area in which the parts of the maguey plant are pulverized using this huge ore. And the process to just break down basically one full-size pulp is between 10 and 18 hours to get this liquid out. And it takes tons of work, tons of effort, highly artisanal, but the results are in the flavor, the results are in the end product. Absolutely delicious. This is an ancient wine thief. I love this. I've never seen this before. Nunca lo he visto. So they place this wine thief into the liquid, and the liquid goes in, gets stopped, and then they give it a taste. This is a traditional bamboo style wine thief. Amazing. Copper still.
Uno ya le va a enterrarla. Prueba este antes.
Este es espadín sin cola. Sin
componer nada, sin cola. Está como a 53, tal vez ahí está.
Ok, y esta es con cola.
No, esa es cola.
Ok, es pura cola. Okay.
¿Vamos a hacer esto?
Ay, ya, claro.
No se mantiene el perlado porque está fuerte de grado alcohólico. Pero lo que vamos a ir haciendo es olerlo. Ahora, vamos a agregarle un poco de cola.
It has tons of complexity. It's unlike anything I've tasted. It sparks memories, like a really good wine that's been aging. Like some birth year wines that I've had from Burgundy give you the same type of reaction. Well, this has been in the earth for 15 years, 18 years sometimes, between that range of 15 and 18 years.
Es que eso se tiene que hacer en ayunas, ahorita con el chile y todo eso no es tan fácil.